In the twilight years of the Cold War, a phantom emerged from the shadows of the United States' most secretive aircraft development programs. The Northrop McDonnell Douglas YF-23 was not just another fighter jet. It was a glimpse into the future of aerial warfare, a revolution in stealth technology that pushed the boundaries of what was thought possible in military aviation. Born from the United States Air Force's Advanced Tactical Fighter Program, the YF-23 was designed to outmaneuver, outrun, and outfight any threat in the skies. Its alien-like appearance, with a 43-foot, 7-inch diamond-shaped wingspan and sawtoothed exhaust nozzles, wasn't just for show. Every curve, every angle of its muscular 67-foot, 5-inch frame was meticulously crafted to achieve unprecedented levels of stealth, making it virtually invisible to enemy radar. But invisibility was just the beginning. Twin state-of-the-art turbofans propelled the YF-23 to blistering speeds with 35,000 pounds of thrust, pushing the aircraft beyond Mach 2. More impressively, it could supercruise, flying supersonic without afterburners, at speeds exceeding Mach 1.6. Its advanced avionics and sensor fusion capabilities, housed within a state-of-the-art cockpit with a 360-degree view, aim to give pilots an almost superhuman awareness of the battle space around them. The YF-23 would go head-to-head with the Lockheed Martin F-22 Raptor in a fiercely fought competition for the Air Force contract, resulting in a controversial decision that continues to be the source of heated debate over 30 years later. The story of the YF-23 began in the early 1980s, amidst growing concerns within the United States Air Force about the capabilities of new Soviet fighters. The introduction of the Mikoyan MiG-29 Fulcrum and Sukhoi Su-27 Flanker posed a significant threat to the United States' aerial dominance, potentially outclassing even the formidable F-15 Eagle. This perceived vulnerability spurred the Air Force to initiate the Advanced Tactical Fighter, or ATF, program in 1981, seeking a next-generation aircraft that could maintain the United States' edge in any potential conflict. The ATF program demanded a quantum leap in fighter technology. The new aircraft would need to incorporate stealth capabilities, supercruise, the ability to sustain supersonic flight without afterburners, and advanced avionics, all while maintaining the agility necessary for air-to-air combat. These requirements pushed the boundaries of what was technologically possible at the time, challenging America's aerospace industry to innovate like never before. Northrop, a company with a rich history in aviation, recognized the opportunity to shape the future of aerial warfare. Partnering with McDonnell Douglas, they assembled a team of the industry's brightest minds to tackle the ATF challenge. Leading this effort was Northrop's ATF program manager, Del Jacobs, who coordinated the work of thousands of engineers and scientists across 30 states. The development process was shrouded in secrecy, befitting the classified nature of the project. The team worked in a windowless, unmarked building on Northrop's campus, with security measures so strict that employees had to park their cars at a distance to avoid detection by Soviet spy satellites. This clandestine environment, coupled with the project's ambitious goals, fostered a sense of urgency and innovation among the staff, who often worked 14-hour days, 7 days a week. As the 1980s progressed, the Northrop McDonnell Douglas team refined their design, leveraging advanced computer simulations and wind tunnel testing. By 1986, their concept had evolved into a unique and promising configuration that would become the YF-23. In October of that year, the Air Force selected Northrop and Lockheed as the two finalists in the ATF competition. Each company was tasked with building two prototype aircraft for evaluation. Northrop's team redoubled their efforts, working tirelessly to transform their design into reality. The YF-23's design was a harmonious blend of stealth and aerodynamic efficiency, representing a significant leap forward in fighter aircraft technology. The fuselage was sleek and elongated, stretching approximately 67 feet 5 inches in length. It featured smooth, blended contours that minimized radar reflections while efficiently managing airflow. The forward section featured a modified double trapezoid cross-section, transitioning seamlessly into a circular profile towards the rear. This careful shaping not only enhanced the aircraft's stealth characteristics, but also reduced transonic and supersonic drag, enabling the YF-23 to achieve remarkable speed and range. Despite its considerable size, the YF-23 maintained a relatively low empty weight of approximately 29,000 pounds, thanks to the extensive use of composite materials and advanced manufacturing techniques. However, its most striking feature was undoubtedly the unconventional diamond-shaped wing platform. Spanning 43 feet 7 inches, the diamond shape offered superior aerodynamic performance across a wide range of speeds compared to traditional swept wings. The leading edge was swept at 40 degrees, while the trailing edge had a forward sweep of 55 degrees. This configuration provided excellent lift characteristics and reduced drag at high speeds, contributing to the aircraft's supercruise capability. The wing design also incorporated advanced airfoils that maintained laminar flow over a larger portion of the wing surface, further reducing drag. The wings were also equipped with leading-edge flaps and trailing-edge elevons. These worked in conjunction with the distinctive V-tail at the rear of the aircraft, which replaced conventional vertical and horizontal stabilizers to provide precise control in all flight regimes. The V-tail surfaces were canted outward at approximately 50 degrees from vertical. This design choice served multiple purposes. It reduced the aircraft's radar signature by eliminating the right-angle intersections typical of conventional tails, improved stability at high speeds, and contributed to the YF-23's impressive maneuverability. The all-moving tail surfaces, dubbed ruddervaders, provided precise control in all flight regimes. They could move independently or in concert to generate pitch, yaw, and roll moments. This innovative control scheme allowed for exceptional agility without compromising the aircraft's stealth characteristics. Powering the YF-23 were two advanced turbofan engines housed in nacelles on either side of the aircraft's spine. These nacelles, larger than what would have been used in a production model, were designed to accommodate potential thrust reversers, a feature later deemed unnecessary. The engines were fed by innovative S-shaped air inlets, which shielded the engine faces from radar waves, further enhancing the aircraft's stealth properties. Each of the two prototypes featured a different engine configuration. One was equipped with Pratt & Whitney YF-119 engines. This engine, which would later be selected for the F-22 Raptor, was a high-thrust, low-bypass turbofan capable of producing approximately 35,000 pounds of thrust with afterburner. Meanwhile, the other prototype utilized the more advanced General Electric YF-120 variable cycle engine, which could adjust its bypass ratio for optimal performance at different flight regimes. Both power plants were cutting-edge designs, enabling the YF-23 to achieve supercruise speeds in excess of Mach 1.6 without afterburners. One of the most innovative features of the YF-23's propulsion system was its exhaust design. Instead of traditional round nozzles, the YF-23 employed two-dimensional, letterbox-shaped exhaust ports. These were integrated into troughs on the upper surface of the aircraft, lined with heat-dissipating tiles similar to those used on the space shuttle. This configuration significantly reduced the aircraft's infrared signature, making it less vulnerable to heat-seeking missiles. Another cornerstone of the YF-23's design was its stealth capabilities. Every aspect of the aircraft was shaped to minimize radar reflections and reduce its overall radar cross-section. The blended wing body design eliminated many of the right angles and sharp edges that typically contribute to an aircraft's radar signature. The YF-23's stealth properties were further enhanced by the use of radar-absorbing materials. These materials were applied to key areas of the airframe, absorbing incoming radar waves rather than reflecting them back to the source. The exact composition of these materials remains classified, but they likely included ferrite-based compounds and carbon-impregnated materials. The aircraft's sensor and avionics apertures were carefully designed to maintain the low observable profile. Antennas and other necessary protrusions were either recessed or covered with radar transparent materials to prevent them from compromising the aircraft's stealth. The YF-23's weapons were to be carried internally in weapons bays to maintain its stealth profile during combat operations. While the prototype aircraft were not equipped with operational weapons systems, the design included provisions for multiple internal bays capable of carrying a variety of air-to-air missiles and possibly air-to-ground ordnance. In the cockpit, the YF-23 featured state-of-the-art avionics and a sophisticated fly-by-wire system. The pilot's station was positioned high in the nose, offering excellent visibility. The cockpit was designed with a large single-piece canopy that provided an unobstructed 360-degree view, crucial for situational awareness in air combat scenarios. The fly-by-wire system was a quadruple redundant digital flight control system that translated pilot inputs into precise control surface movements. This system allowed for exceptional maneuverability and stability across the aircraft's entire flight envelope, from low-speed, high-angle-of-attack flight to supersonic cruise. While the prototypes were not equipped with full combat systems, they were designed to accommodate advanced sensor suites and electronic warfare systems. The production version was expected to include an active electronically scanned array radar, infrared search and track system, and a comprehensive electronic warfare suite. The first YF-23 prototype, PAVE-1, was rolled out on June 22, 1990. It was informally known as Spider or Black Widow 2 due to the red hourglass shape that was originally painted on its ram air scoop to prevent injury to ground crew, which resembled the markings on a Black Widow spider's belly. The nickname also suggested that it was the successor to the World War II era Northrop P-61 Black Widow. On August 27th, it took to the skies from Edwards Air Force Base with Northrop test pilot Paul Metz at the controls. The 50-minute maiden flight marked the beginning of an intensive testing program that would push the aircraft to its limits and beyond. On October 26, the second prototype, PAV-2, nicknamed the Gray Ghost, was flown for the first time by Jim Sandberg. Over the next several months, both YF-23 prototypes underwent rigorous flight testing. Both aircraft demonstrated exceptional performance, achieving supercruise speeds of Mach 1.43 in the Pratt and Whitney YF, 119 powered PAV-1, and an impressive Mach 1.6 in the General Electric YF-120 equipped PAV-2. The YF-23's high-speed capabilities and superior stealth characteristics seemed to position it favorably in the competition against Lockheed's YF-22. The testing phase revealed the YF-23's exceptional stability and control characteristics. Test pilots reported that the aircraft was highly responsive and easy to handle, even at high speeds and altitudes. The innovative V-tail configuration proved effective in providing precise control without compromising stealth. During high angle of attack testing, the YF-23 demonstrated the ability to maintain controlled flight at angles up to 60 degrees, showcasing its potential effectiveness in close-range air combat scenarios. The aircraft's thrust-to-weight ratio and low wing loading contributed to its impressive climb rates and sustained turn performance. However, the competition was far from one-sided. While the YF-23 excelled in speed and stealth, the YF-22 demonstrated superior agility, particularly in low-speed, high-angle-of-attack maneuvers. This disparity would prove crucial in the Air Force's final evaluation. Throughout the testing phase, the Northrop team continued to refine the YF-23's design, addressing minor issues and optimizing its performance. The aircraft's fly-by-wire system was fine-tuned to enhance its handling characteristics, while its stealth features were continuously evaluated and improved. Despite the YF-23's impressive capabilities, the Air Force announced in April 1991 that it had selected the Lockheed YF-22 as the winner of the ATF competition. The decision came as a blow to the Northrop team, who had poured years of effort and innovation into their design. Several factors contributed to the YF-22's selection. Its superior agility was seen as a critical advantage in close-range air combat. Additionally, the Air Force perceived the YF-22 as a less risky option, with a more conventional design that was closer to existing fighter aircraft. There were also considerations beyond pure performance, including assessments of production readiness and long-term development potential. With the competition's conclusion, the two YF-23 prototypes were retired. The project that had once consumed the efforts of thousands of engineers and technicians across the country came to an abrupt end. The aircraft that had pushed the boundaries of stealth and speed would never see production or combat service. Several decades later, discussion continues to abound about whether the correct decision was made. Although the YF-23 never entered production, its impact on aviation technology and fighter design has been significant and lasting. The advanced stealth techniques developed for the YF-23, believed by many to have been superior to those of the F-22, have influenced subsequent aircraft designs, contributing to the evolution of low observable technology. The YF-23's innovative aerodynamics, particularly its diamond-shaped wing and V-tail configuration, demonstrated new possibilities in aircraft design. These concepts have informed the development of other advanced aircraft, pushing the boundaries of what is possible in terms of speed, maneuverability, and stealth. The advancements in the propulsion system, especially the integration of engines for reduced infrared signature, have had lasting impacts on military aviation. The supercruise capability, once a novel concept, has become a standard feature in fifth-generation fighters. The YF-23's fly-by-wire system and advanced cockpit design laid the groundwork for future developments in aircraft control and pilot interface. The emphasis on sensor fusion and integrated avionics has become a hallmark of modern fighter aircraft design. Today, the two YF-23 prototypes serve as reminders of this remarkable chapter in aviation history. One aircraft is displayed at the National Museum of the United States Air Force in Dayton, Ohio, while the other resides at the Western Museum of Flight in Torrance, California. These preserved examples continue to inspire engineers, aviation enthusiasts, and the public, showcasing the cutting-edge technology and bold innovation that characterize the Advanced Tactical Fighter Program. The YF-23 stands as a testament to American aerospace ingenuity. While it may not have won the ATF competition, its legacy lives on in the advancements it pioneered and the boundaries it pushed. In the annals of aviation history, the YF-23 remains a symbol of the relentless pursuit of technological excellence and the endless quest for air superiority.